Hello everyone, my name is Kent and welcome back to my workshop. I started to record my machining work during June 2016, and those recordings have come in handy several times to learn from my own mistakes. This fun video is a collection of mistakes made during 2016. I hope you enjoy the video and have the best of success in the new year.
In this clip, I learned about lead-in versus feed rate in Fusion 360 and tool pull-out. The tool should clear the fixed draw plate by a few hundred thousandths of an inch. The tool is currently moving slowly, which is the lead-in rate of Fusion 360, and then will accelerate to the feed rate. When using a slow lead-in rate, it's tempting to increase the feed override, but this can lead to surprising results. The aggressive cut causes the tool to pull out slightly and collides with the fixed jaw plate. The ability of the carbide tool to cut the hardened jaw plates is impressive, at least until the tool chips. This clip is of making a spacer that mounts to the top of a linear rail block. The part is being contoured using a 1/8 inch end mill, leaving tabs calculated by Fusion 360 to hold the part in place. Once reaching feed rate, after a long slow ramp in, the end mill just snaps off. This was using the default rates in Fusion 360, and I've since created a cloud library with tailored feed rates that are less aggressive for my smaller machine. Continuing that theme, two more 1/8 inch end mills snap off. The second one did cut a lot of material before it finally broke. Replacing this multi-depth 2D pocketing operation with a 2D adaptive clearing operation resulted in a faster operation and no more breakage.
Okay, I didn't have a 256 tap, so I had to go to Hobby Haven, and thankfully they had one in stock. I like the other tap guide better.
This clip can best be explained as carelessness. Regardless of the tap guide that's being used, the tap needs to be retracted before the part is moved. Thankfully, I was able to grind the stub of a tap and finish the remaining holes. This was probably the most sickening mistake. A number of problems conspired, causing a servo to fall, allowing the weight of the head to come down and rest upon a Hymer probe. Thankfully, the probe continues to work fine today. This clip is another example of tool pull-out, and it was the first time I actually recognized the problem. I hadn't recognized the problem in the earlier clip that we saw until making this outtakes video. If I had been more observant while making this part, I would have noticed that the 3D interpolated angle doesn't go all the way to the top. These carbide tools are impressive, and even after cutting this hardened faceplate, since the tool is not chip, it still works well. This event forced me to learn about proper drawbar torquing, especially if using TTS tooling, and to construct a new drawbar that's easier to torque to spec. I'm a believer in the future of 3D printing, but 3D printing at home as it is currently is an endless source of frustration. This is a TAS-5 3D printer printing PLA material. The part was designed in Fusion 360 and exported as STL to Simplify 3D, where G-code was generated. This clip is just one of many I have from 2016 of 3D printing effectively abstract bird nests. While I'll continue to experiment with 3D printing at home, for the new year I'm also going to try services like ProtoLabs. The part being cut in this clip is a heatsink. Because of the size and the need to fully support the part, I can't hold it on a vise. Instead, it's clamped and screwed to a piece of MDF. A lot of care was taken to lap the surface to make it as flat as possible for best heat transfer. But as the coolant absorbed into the MDF after hours of milling, the MDF distorted the workpiece. I was afraid that the workpiece was destroyed, but after unscrewing it from the MDF, the part snapped back into shape. Some of the valleys between the fins are thinner than others, but the part works well nonetheless. This clip is of a part being clipped by a tool. The tool path suggested this shouldn't occur. By default, Linux CNC has path blending enabled, and some configuration was necessary to avoid this problem. In this clip, cutouts are being made into a wooden panel for gauges. The wooden panel is held to a sacrificial piece of wood by double-sided tape. This method works surprisingly well, but sometimes the tape does let go. Adding a few screws to the through hole solved the problem. Thank you for watching, and a special thank you to those who subscribed in 2016, the beginning of this channel. Your support is greater than I ever expected, and I'm looking forward to a wonderful 2017. Until the next video, thank you.